Morgan, a native of Moorhead, Minnesota, 3.5 hours northwest of here. He started it out and lugged in by Geeky. Fed to the slot, and Oleksiak's shot got turned aside with traffic in front on Fleury. Draws a penalty, Fleury to the bench. Hartman's pass broken up, and Minnesota will go on a power play here with that traffic and collision.
In the first 5+ minutes, good job getting out of their zone, using the wall to break out. Oleksiak joins the rush, and you can see Schwartz, I don't think it was intentional. He's trying to get out of the way of the shot, but look where Fleury is. I mean, he's outside.
Here's Strong with speed. Strong takes it wide, throw it off the post, and a rebound turned aside by Fleury on Yanni Gourde.
Here so far in the first period of Seattle, terrific job by Sprong carrying the mail, and a smart play, either get it at the feet or off the side of the net and see if he can get a second chance opportunity. Exactly what happens, you can see it goes right off the side of the net, and Fleury was able to come up with their goaltender was good to start the game, a good kill, and then they get to work after the TV timeout. Good work by Boldy to possess the puck and then get it to an area where he can get some help from Johansson, and then a real smart play here. Fakes the shot, and that's what allows Middleton to be wide open. Two Kraken players go to the middle to block the shot. Middleton's there, and he gets a clean look at it. I think Eriksson-Ek provides a little bit of a screen in front of Grubauer as his shot comes in. You can see they want to send a message toward the end of that period with the physicality. Let's see if that continues here in the next 40.
He's fully clothed now, so are we. We start the second.
You got tattoos like that, you got ink like that, you may as well show it off.
Spurgeon adjusts at the line, held it in, now Boldy works it to the goal line in the near side corner for Zuccarello. Touched along the line, held in there by Spurgeon. Johansson fires the seam pass. Boldy scores! That is gorgeous on the Wild power play, and it is 2-0 Minnesota.
Back to the Wild. I mean, this guy can pass the puck, and he has been really good in this game so far. Watch this game. Cross team. Oleksiak caught down low. I don't know if he lost where Zuccarello was, but he was really covering nobody. And Tanev not able to get a stick in the lane. And when Boldy gets the puck in that area, he is awfully dangerous. This guy can shoot the puck, and obviously he's playing with a lot of confidence.
One of my first concerts was OAR, by the way. Nice to meet the fellas from up top. Larson worked it toward the net. Here's Strong shivering. Tanev on a backhand. And Fleury makes a stop.
Boy, has he been good tonight, Fleury.
Save of the game brought to you by Synchrony Bank Saver.
Yeah, this is the best one, no question. The one on Tanev. You know, that puck comes to the front. Watch the footwork of Fleury with the right skate, able to push back and then extend that left. Right there, he catches his edge with his right skate and then pushed back with his left leg. Yeah, he showed some promise in Ottawa. I can tell you that.
Boldy scores again! Wow! Ho-ho-ho!
I should know that when the puck is on Boldy's stick, you know, to be quiet. I mean, he's shooting pucks from all over the ice. This one seems to be from the third row of the rink, yet difficult for goaltenders to pick up the puck, and here off the ensuing face-off, a win for Eriksson-Ek. Boldy just gets to a spot and just, he uses the Seattle player as a screen. Watch here as Beniers, he just shoots it right through his legs, and almost impossible for Grubauer to pick it up. And even on top of that, for Grubauer, he's not thinking that Boldy's gonna put the puck on the net from that area.
With inside of 5 to go in this second period here in St. Paul.
Now let's see if that goal kind of breaks the will of Seattle.
Johansson right out of front, and he sets one off the post. Nearly made it 4-0.
Oleksiak hangs in there. He doesn't have support, and that's what allows the Wild to get this chance. And Johansson, who's been so good at distributing the puck here. Nice little flip shot. You can see he gets Grubauer to move and just.
And you talked earlier in the first period about his development and how the Wild approached it with him. He's only 21, but in some ways, a longer road to get to this point.
Longer road, and he took it.
He's got Minnesota up 3-0 here on Seattle. First minute of this third, and how did the Kraken respond? You talked about the top line for them and the impact that was felt by Seattle early on. What else do you want to see from them as they turn it over? And Boldy! Oh, man! He is hot! It's a hat trick for Boldy! Right on cue!
Well, the Wild maybe didn't start the way they wanted to in the first 15 minutes of the game, but they've taken over here. A little bit of sloppy play from the Kraken to start the period. Schultz a little slow to get the puck up the ice. The pressure by the Wild and Boldy, who, the one thing about him, he just has the ability. Let's see how Jones fares now that the Wild are pressing here with a 4-goal lead.
McCann stripped Johansson, dropped it off for Beniers. Everly, and a save blur. He has had a big night as well. Now for Dave Hextall, the Kraken. Off toward McCann. Didn't get all the way through to him, and Johansson speeds back. Foligno with him. Foligno turned aside by Jones. And a penalty coming. It is a slash.
And creates the turnover here. Wenberg turnover, and then off to the races go Johansson. We talked about his skating. He's able to get a step.
From the right point now, Johansson. Goal line in the corner. Along for Spurgeon midpoint. Here's Boldy wheel. Boldy. Oh, a beautiful setup. And Erickson Ek denied by Jones.
To the bumper in the slot. And Boldy here on his strong side gets it down to the goal line. Johansson, the one touch to Erickson Ek. And
Gord behind the net. Tried to work it out toward Bjorkstrand. Now on a pinch from Schultz. Cut off there by Merrill. Flipped out toward the line. And Zuccarello guides it out of harm's way. Now he feeds Hartman, joining the rush. Hartman shoots and scores! It is all Minnesota tonight.
Behind the goal line. Here he just, a nice intercept. Flips it to an area where Zuccarello can make a play. It's the end of the shift for Zuccarello, and he finds Hartman. And then a real skillful play here by Hartman to get this puck around the stick of Carson Soucy and then shoot it through that triangle. And where he shoots it is, you know, Martin Jones is moving off his post ever so slightly.
Bill Guerin told us earlier today, same injury Gus Nyquist has. That one held out, and on a redirect, they score. Larson in front. Schwartz working hard for Seattle, who is on the board with 9 minutes to go with some Plinko here in the third.
Continue to compete and grind, and they're able to get one. I mean, look, you don't like to see the opposition goaltender get a shutout, so continue to get the puck to the net. A good redirect initially by Geeky, I believe. He gets a stick on it as his puck comes in off the initial shot by Dunn. And that redirect goes off the post, and from that point on, it was absolute scramble mode for Marc-Andre Fleury.
Geeky squeezed to the wall there by Middleton, who was stickless. Dunn still with it. Dunn through the skates and then off the post from Geeky.
The Kraken do, and trying to find a way to get it to three. And just a no-quit mentality to this group.
Did the work offensively with his second hat trick in the last five games for the Wild, who continue to get it done without Kirill Kaprizov. And Matt Boldy once again the headliner for Minnesota.